SyncFing is my companion if it comes to file synchronization. But in Windows I have a major problem. I'm not able to configure auto start and notification settings. So we need a wrapper to get this done. My favorite wrapper until now was SyncTracer, which you now can see in the video. The only problem with SyncTracer is that it's out of date, and since 2021 there have been no updates at all on its GitHub page. After the intro, I would like to show you an alternative. Stay with me. So before we start to install an alternative, I like to show you where SyncFing is saving its configuration files, but also the database of the synced files. Open your Windows Explorer, go into this address bar here and type percent, the symbol of percent, and local app data, if I remember correctly, and close it with a percent symbol. You will now see this path. Heinz is replaced with your username, of course, and here we can search, or we can find at least SyncFing. Before we start to do anything here, you should back up this folder. So I'm now closing SyncTracer and wait a moment. Now I do a right click on SyncFing and choose the copy option. And I go to documents, and with a right click I can paste this folder. So we have now a proper backup and can now start to install a new wrapper. Before we install the new one, we should of course delete the old one. I'm a big fan of Winget, and therefore I will use Winget to uninstall my applications. You can do this by right clicking on your Windows flag on your taskbar and select Terminal Admin. Confirm the next dialog with yes, and we start typing Winget remove sync tracer. That's it. So now we can install SyncFing Tray. Why SyncFing Tray? SyncFing Tray is up to date and it's available for all platforms. And the best way to install it is really to use Winget. Don't try to do it on your own, because you have to take care where to place the .exe file and so on. Just use Winget or Chocolate or whatever package manager you use on Windows, but Winget is already pre-installed on Windows 11. Winget install SyncFing Tray. You may now see that the version is pretty outdated, but I'm already on it to get an update from the Winget packages page. So perhaps if you see this video, there's already an update out and you will get a newer version here. So that's it. The only thing you have to do, you have to open up a new PowerShell window here. And now I'm starting to type SyncFing Tray, and with tab, with a tabulator key, you can use autocomplete. With enter, we can start it. And we are now using the wizard. So we select start guided setup. We select the first option. We use the included version of SyncFing. I also select start SyncFing Tray on login. This is basically the auto start option in Windows. And I press apply. And click finish. So what I can see here is now that SyncFing is started. I have my old configuration already imported, so the backup in this case was useless, but better safe than sorry. So you can now delete your backup. The only thing left now is to make sure that this SyncFing icon is visible forever, and I can do it by doing a right click here, taskbar settings, and other system tray icons. And here I should be able to find tray application for SyncFing. Tick this on, and now you can see that it's available here and it will never disappear. If you want to access your SyncFing web interface, you can just click this tiny button here, and then your standard browser will open up with SyncFing. If you dislike to open it in your browser, as I do, there's a small option you can change. We open up SyncFing Tray, go here in options, and here in web view, we can change the behavior. We select Chromium based browser in app mode. We can leave everything else empty. We can change some options here, but just ignore it and press apply. Now I can open up this button again. And as you see, I have an extra window here, like I'm used from Sync Tracer. It does not mess up or does not interfere with my normal browser. So I'm more happy to have a separate window here and not have it in my browser. Thanks for watching this video, and you know how to support this channel.